I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, president of the Florida Society of Neurology, here with MS World. A lot of times we get questions with people with MS about vision and what happens if vision gets dull. Are there any ways of treating that? So the first question is whether the visual problems have to do with multiple sclerosis. People with MS may also have other reasons for visual problems. But even when we think that it is caused by something like optic neuritis, remember, optic is like the eye, neur is the nerve, itis means inflammation. When that happens, we think, well, if this is an MS relapse, then we should treat it like an MS relapse. And we know that there's two FDA-approved treatments for MS relapse. One involves IV methylprednisolone or IV selumetrol, and the other one is about a medication we've heard about called IM intramuscular or subcutaneous ACTH or HP Acthar gel. But what happens if you've gone through those treatments and the vision still doesn't get better? Well, sometimes your doctor may go ahead and give you more of those treatments. Other times they may switch from one to another. They may go ahead and use off-label. When we say off-label, what we mean is the Food and Drug Administration has not said that that treatment is approved for that reason. But a lot of times your doctors will use things in an off-label way. We may use off-label plasmapheresis, which is almost like a hemodialysis in a way, a cleaning out of the blood, as well as something called IVIG or intravenous immunoglobulin, also called IGIV. What happens if, despite all those things, you're left with some visual problems? Well, while we don't have a medicine that's particularly specifically FDA approved for the consequences of that optic neuritis, what we do have is we have ways of trying to speed up the conduction of nerves. You've heard about a medication called dalfampridine ER extended release, also known as Ampira. This drug is FDA approved for walking in MS. It's not FDA approved for vision in MS, but some doctors think that because it helps the nerve conduct electricity better, that can be useful in the eye as well. So it's important to go speak to your doctor and figure out what exactly is going on with your eye, whether you need any further testing or don't need any further testing, whether you need to see an eye doctor or not see an eye doctor, and then also what your treatment options are for you. Thank you for joining us.